In this video, we'll look at purchasing power parity and analyze the implications of purchasing power differentials. Purchasing power parity is a method used to adjust exchange rates for the differences in purchasing power between nations. Since the same goods and services have different prices around the world, purchasing power will differ from the simple conversion of the exchange rate. In a moment, we will look at a sample market basket in the United States, and then we will compare it to the same market basket in Canada using the given exchange rate. Before continuing, you should note that in this video, the dollar symbol by itself will represent the US dollar. When you see the letter C preceding the dollar symbol, it is a reference to the Canadian dollar. In the United States, this market basket of goods costs about $10. One soda, one ice cream, and one loaf of bread together cost 10 US dollars. How much do these identical products cost in Canada? Well, in Canada, the same market basket of goods costs about 12.8 Canadian dollars. We'll need the nominal exchange rate to answer the following question. Does the purchasing power parity match the exchange rate? We will use the exchange rate from December 12, 2020, where one US dollar is equal to 1.28 Canadian dollars. If this market basket costs $10 in the US, it should cost 12.8 Canadian dollars in Canada. Since it does, the purchasing power parity exchange rate is the same as the nominal exchange rate. Now, what would happen if purchasing power differed in between two countries? To simplify, we will only consider one good, specifically a can of Coca-Cola, as representative of the prices in the US and Canadian economies. Given our previous exchange rate of 1 US dollar to 1.28 Canadian dollars, we can see in this table that a Coca-Cola is twice as expensive in Canada as it is in the US. Let's break this information down further. For every 1.28 Canadian dollars the Canadians exchange, they will receive 1 US dollar. Adjusting for the value of the Canadian dollar to the US dollar, 1 Canadian dollar equals 0.78 US dollars. If a Canadian exchanges 2.56 Canadian dollars, they will receive 2 US dollars. This will allow Canadians to purchase 2 cans of Coca-Cola in the United States. Another way to look at this is, instead of using 256 Canadian dollars to purchase 100 cans of Coca-Cola in Canada, they should travel to the US, convert to 200 US dollars, and purchase 200 cans of Coca-Cola there. Essentially, one can of Canadian Coca-Cola is equivalent to 2 cans of US Coca-Cola. The real exchange rate between the two countries is equal to 2 cans of US Coca-Cola per can of Canadian Coca-Cola, or 0.5 cans of Canadian Coca-Cola per can of US Coca-Cola. In currency terms, this means the real exchange rate should be 1 US dollar to 2.56 Canadian dollars. Since the nominal exchange rate is 1.28 Canadian dollars to 1 US dollar, the real exchange rate of 2.56 Canadian dollars to 1 US dollar suggests that the Canadian currency is overvalued and should depreciate to reach its true value. If these price differentials occurred across all goods and services in the economy, Canadians would purchase more US imports and likely sell fewer exports to the US. This movement of currency would increase the demand for US dollars and also increase the supply of Canadian dollars. This would result in a depreciation of the Canadian dollar and an appreciation of the US dollar as they both move toward parity. Let's use the same countries again, but this time we will cut the price of a Canadian can of Coca-Cola to 64 Canadian cents. Given our nominal exchange rate of 1 US dollar to 1.28 Canadian dollars, we can see in this table that a Coca-Cola is actually half the price in Canada relative to the US. For every $1 the US Americans exchange, they will receive 1.28 Canadian dollars. At the given prices, this will allow US Americans to purchase 2 cans of Coca-Cola. Instead of using $100 to purchase 100 cans of Coca-Cola in the US, they should travel to Canada, convert to 128 Canadian dollars, and purchase 200 cans of Coca-Cola over there. Essentially, one can of US Coca-Cola is equivalent to two cans of Canadian Coca-Cola. The real exchange rate equals 0.5 cans of US Coca-Cola per can of Canadian Coca-Cola, or two cans of Canadian Coca-Cola per can of US Coca-Cola. In currency terms, this means that the real exchange rate should be one US dollar to 0.64 Canadian dollars. If the current exchange rate is 1.28 Canadian dollars to one US dollar, and the real exchange rate is actually 0.64 Canadian dollars to the US dollar, this situation suggests that the Canadian currency is undervalued and should appreciate to reach its true value. If these price differentials occurred across all goods and services in the economy, Canadians would purchase less US imports and likely sell more exports to the US. This movement of currency would increase the demand of Canadian dollars and also increase the supply of US dollars. This would result in an appreciation of the Canadian dollar and a depreciation of the US dollar as they both moved toward parity. In reality, exchange rates do not reach purchasing power parity. They may move towards it in the long run, but in the short run, they can fluctuate significantly with respect to parity. There are additional limitations of purchasing power parity theory to consider as well. Finding perfectly comparable market baskets across countries is difficult. To find identical goods that are produced to an identical quality is nearly impossible when comparing a large basket of goods and services in two countries. Second, nominal exchange rates do not automatically adjust to changes in purchasing power parity due to restrictions on imports and exports, in part. Not every good can be easily and cheaply transported from one country to another. There are trade restrictions and import and export controls that limit how easily goods can move. Beyond this, tariffs can offset cost savings that importing can generate. Thirdly, you cannot export certain services like haircuts or domestic care. Finally, and this was mentioned earlier, transport costs are a significant factor in moving goods from one country to another. Even in the absence of trade barriers, you are still required to transport goods to take advantage of price differentials. This can result in significant transportation costs that will reduce the benefit of purchasing goods in the relatively cheaper country. So by now, you should have a much clearer understanding of purchasing power parity and its implications for exchange rates. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's try to answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.